737, call my daughter to Scott. Oh, won't you take me down to Memphis on a meeting? Never, I don't want to move. Hey, you need a traveling pain. Yeah. Hello again, everyone. It's TJ, the Stereo Bargain Found. From that quick intro, I'm sure you all have already guessed it. I am very fired up today, you all, to finally bring you my full video review of my personal reference stand mount speakers, my Triangle 40th Anniversary Edition Comites. Now, these stand mount speakers were made over in France. That's right, y'all. They were made over in France, and I can tell you right now, the pair that I bought, they come with a real wood veneer, Santos Rosewood. These are some sexy looking speakers, you all. I mean, to me, these are the French kiss of stand mount speakers. And I will get to that here shortly. But anyways, I want to start this video out real quick for you all. I want to go over some size and dimensions and specs and features of the 40th Comite. And then, yes, I will talk about their overall sound performance. And I'll have a little comparison for you all against a speaker here behind me that I reviewed about a year ago. Now, that is the Triangle Esprit Easy Comite. Now, the 40th Comite is basically a high-performance version of the regular Easy Comite. But anyways, right now, as you all can tell, it is very hard for my video camera to get a good look at these gorgeous-looking speakers. So right now, I'm going to give you all a very good close-up look. So let's go. Okay, you all, before I kick off this full video review of the Triangle 40th Anniversary Comites, I wanted to go ahead and give you all a close-up look. My video camera has a very hard time giving you a good image of these speakers because they have such a high gloss shine. Now, the 40th Comites that I bought, you all, actually come with a real wood veneer called Santos Rosewood. Now, let's go up through the sides. Now, on my community page, I have a lot of pictures for you all if you want to check out. These are just so gorgeous, y'all. Now, let's go to the back. Now, we're at the back of the stand mount speakers. I mean, such a high gloss shine, you all. Here at the bottom, we have our five-way binding post, which has locking banana plugs, meaning if you use banana plugs, you can lock them in. I actually have a very strong neodymium magnet, and I always test out my five-way binding posts to make sure they're not magnetic, which these aren't. These are fully built in France. So now let's take a real quick look at the speaker stands. I actually bought the matching speaker stands from Sound Approach. On the bottom, they have four very good size spikes to help for grounding. Then in this middle piece that you see here in front of you all, the stands will come with like three bags that you put down inside of them, and then those bags you fill up with sand. That way you don't hear that ringing effect from having metal stands. No ringing at all. And then of course up at the top we have a big mounting plate that's almost the size of the bottom of the speaker, and this helps to give good grounding. Okay, let's jump into this, y'all. You all see why I had to give you all that close-up look of the Triangle 40th Anniversary Edition Comites. I mean, you all, this Santos Rosewood veneer with that high-gloss shine looks gorgeous. But if it's not to your taste, then Triangle also has the Sycamore Edition. Now, one thing I will tell you about the 40th Comite is the engineers just didn't go for better looks. They almost totally revamped this stand mount speaker, and I'm going to go over that with you all right now, and then I will go over the price point with you all because the price point was revamped also. One of the first things you'll notice in front of this speaker is it's a two-way design, and we have basically a horn-loaded design, or what Triangle calls their compression chamber. Now, when we start talking about the 1-inch metal dome tweeter and the version behind me, the Triangle Esprit Easy Comite, that was a 1-inch titanium dome tweeter, which the new 40th Comite comes with Triangle's new engineered magnesium dome tweeter. Now, magnesium is lighter and has more rigidity. And I can tell you all, there is a big difference in sound performance, and there should be at the price point. Now, the one thing I will tell you is that Triangle calls
this magnesium dome tweeter. They call it their TZ2520MG. MG, I guess, just meaning magnesium. But it also has that anodized rosewood color to it. That actually triangle used with their five-way binding post also. Then down below that, we have, of course, our 6.5-inch driver. Now, this 6.5-inch driver has been totally revamped also, you all. We have a new suspension, a new motor design, and Triangle done this to give, you know, a wider spectrum of sound. But not only that, y'all, the cone is made out of 100% cellulose paper with reinforced wood fibers. And one thing I can tell you all is when I crank up that volume, to be a 6.5-inch driver, I am very, very, very impressed. Another thing that Triangle Engineers did with the 40th Comet over the regular Triangle Esprit Easy Comet behind me is they got more reinforcement inside of the speaker cabinet. I mean, the speaker cabinet itself with the real wood veneer measures up to 23 millimeters thick. Now, that is impressive, y'all. Not only that, the speaker cabling inside, not only is it oxygen-free copper, but it also has PVC jacket going over top of that cabling inside. And the crossover inside has been redone as well. So what I'm going to do for y'all, down in my description box below, I'm going to upload a 3-minute video for you all. And this is a video that the engineers at Triangle put out. And they put this out and they show you how they build these speakers. You know, they're in there putting them together, building the drivers, buffing out the speaker cabinets. So I'm going to upload that for you all so I don't have to take the speaker out and show you all the inside. So now, I want to get straight into talking about the size and dimensions of the 40th Comet. Now, first off, the weight is 8.8 kilograms or 19.4 pounds. Now, let's talk about the dimensions. The width from side to side of the speaker cabinet is 200 millimeters or 7.9 inches. Now, when we talk about how tall the stand mount speaker is just itself, it is 15.7 inches tall or 400 millimeters tall. Now, the depth of the speaker. How deep is the speaker? And this measures 13 inches deep, you all, or 12.7 inches. Well, 12.7 to 13, I'm not exact on that. But anyways, it's 324 millimeters deep. So now that I've wrapped that up, y'all, it is time for me to talk about the overall sound performance of the Triangle 40th Anniversary Edition Comet. Shout out to my guy Joel Bonamassa as I've done a CD playback of his live performance album live from the Albert Hall. I tell you all, Joel Bonamassa really gets me pumped up, and that's what I needed to bring you all my full, subjective, humble opinion of the sound performance of Triangle's very own 40th Anniversary Edition Comet. But first, you all, I want to give a big shout out and a big thank you to my go-to guy at Triangle, Frank. Now, Frank heads up the U.S. Distribution Center of Triangle Speakers. And one thing I want to tell you all is a real quick story. When I very first heard that Triangle was coming out with their 40th Anniversary Edition Comet, I had to jump on the boat very quickly, you all. I mean, I ordered the 40th 2 months before the cargo ship even arrived in the bay here in the good old US of A. So yes, I have had these speakers for almost 11 months. That's right, y'all. Almost 11 months. Now, the reason why it's taken me such a long time to get to my video review is because I have about a dozen Class A or Class AB amplifiers that I wanted to pair up with the 40th Comete. And the reason for that is I want to get a better perspective of its overall sound performance. So again, I want to give a big shout out thank you to Frank. Thank you, Frank. Now, one thing I will tell you all is I did buy the 40th anniversary Comete speakers. Now, normally, you all, I review budget speakers, meaning speakers that are $1,500 US and less. But, you know, I wanted to, you know, step in and hear what an entry-level speaker could bring to the table for me, because the Triangle 40th comes in at a price tag of $2,500 US. That is correct, you all, $2,500 US. And you know, it was just about a couple months ago, the only way you could buy the 40th anniversary edition Comete's was to go to a dealer. Which, one thing I will tell you all, before buying any speakers, I highly recommend that you audition them first. But one of the cool things for us over here in the U.S. is we don't have to go to a dealer anymore to buy these speakers. There's this really cool company called Sound Approach. And Sound Approach, this audio company, they do sell these speakers. So down in the description box below, I will upload their link for you all. And they have a very good reputation. I have talked to them on the phone. I have read up on comments of what their customers' feedback has been with their experience of Sound Approach. And it's been very good. So Sound Approach, you make for a very easy recommendation. And no, you all, not at all do I make any money off saying that. As many of you all have followed this channel know, 95% of the audio gear and speakers that I review, I buy them. That's right. I personally, I buy them. So now, let's go ahead and jump straight into my subjective humble opinion of the overall sound performance of the Triangle 40th. Now, first off, you all, I want to talk about the soundstage, because the soundstage of these 40th Comete's, you all, is very large. There's a lot of depth, height, and width to the overall sound. Now, as you can see back here, I have my regular Triangle Esprit Easy Comet. Now, I hate to call them regular, but you know, they do come in at $1,400 US, and for their price point, they are a good bang for the buck. And actually, the reason I bought the 40th Anniversary Edition Comete's. But between the two, you know, there's about a $900 to $1,000 US price gap in between them. But one thing I noticed when I first hooked up the 40th anniversary speakers, y'all, when I got them, is the first thing that came to my mind. And I even texted Thomas at Thomas and Stereo, and even Sean at Zero to Fidelity. And I told them, if I could say one word that described these 40th Comete's, you all, it would be high performance. Because you all know I'm normally used to reviewing and buying budget speakers that are $1,500 and less. And again, I wanted to hear what an entry-level speaker could bring to the table. And when it comes to soundstage, you all, let me tell you something. The 40th, they blew me away. I am telling y'all, the overall spatialness of the soundstage, oh baby, it is very good, you all, going beyond the plane of the speaker cabinet. And when I'm listening to one of my favorite musical instruments, and that is the electric guitar, y'all, when I'm listening to CDs like my Joe Bonamassa up here and a couple others I wanted to share with you all, my Carlos Santana Africa Speaks CD, awesome CD. Another one's my Niles Lofgren Grin, another awesome CD with a lot of electric guitar on it. And last but not least, Dire Straits' Sultan of Swing. And y'all, when I'm sitting back listening to the electric guitar, the sound just hung into the air and seemed to decay slowly into oblivion. And I was like, oh my goodness. You know, this was very impressive. The time arrival that Triangle engineers got right with this 40th Comete. I mean, the tweeter don't even cross over to 3.8 kilohertz into the woofer. Now, most speakers will cross over between 2 and 2.5 kilohertz. But the engineers at Triangle crossed it over at 3.8 kilohertz, and that timing arrival, I tell you all, instrument separation is outstanding. And you know, compared to my regular Triangle Easy Comet, yes, the 40th Comete is a step above, and it should be for the difference in its price point. But another thing that really got me, y'all, with the 40th Comete was piano playback. Now, I've been listening to piano for a very long time, since I was a small child. My mom always played piano. She even was our church's pianist. And one thing I can tell you about the Triangles, not only are they a very good dynamic speaker, but the dynamics with piano and the attack, that initial struck of the keys, you get a real good sense of how hard the pianist strikes the keys. That's something I don't see a whole lot of with my budget speakers. And I absolutely love that, y'all. So now, let's go ahead and talk about the top end. What is the top end sound, TJ, of the 40th Comete? Yes, this is a horn design, and it does have a forward and revealing presentation. But it's not like you're sitting in the front row of a concert. It's rather you're sitting back in the fourth or fifth row of the concert. The top end has this sweet, enjoyable sparkle to the sound, y'all. It's like the Triangle engineers sprinkled just the right amount of treble volume into the top end to keep the speaker away from sounding too edgy, too sharp. I mean, when I'm listening to cymbals, you all, and bells and violins, and even Bob Dylan's harmonica. That's right, you all, Bob Dylan's harmonica. Let me find it for you. Here's two of my CDs by Bob Dylan. Now, you know, on some speakers, when you're listening to his harmonica, yes, it can be a little bit irritable, too edgy, you know, too sharp. But when I'm listening to it through the 40th anniversary edition Comete, you all, it actually sounds pleasing. It has a softness to it. But at the same time, Triangle still, these speakers, the 40th, dig deep into the micro details. It's peeling back the layers of music. And I'm telling you all, I've never heard a harmonic sound so good. I mean, overall, the top end sound character has a real maturity to it. Very mature sounding, because I know there's a lot of people out there that do not like the sound of a horn speaker. And one thing I would tell those kind of people, I hope someday that you get to audition the 40th, because that may just change your mind. So now, let's talk about the mid-body sound of the Triangle 40th. Body sound character, or the mid-range sound character of the Triangle 40th Comete. Now, first off, to me, this is the star of the show with the 40th. Now, the 40th's mid-range is on the warm side of neutral, but it has this smooth and lush, inviting sound character to y'all. When I'm listening to drums playback, I just don't hear the drum, y'all. I can hear the skin of the drum with the 40th. Texture and tonality have a realness to them, you all. When I'm listening to my CDs that have a lot of drums playback, like Agnes and Julie Stone, there's one of my CDs. Here's another Agnes and Julie Stone CD, and Jazz at the Pawn Shop. You all, when I listen to these CDs, my jaw about hits the floor. I mean, I was so impressed with drum playback. I'm just not hearing the drum. I'm hearing what type of drum I'm listening to. Another awesome feature is the male and female vocals. I mean, this is a very strong point of the 40th Comete. The vocals have a natural sound to them. Even in my music room, it is almost like the artist is in my room. Now, when I compare the 40th Comete against the EZ Comete, yes, I could hear more emotion in the singer's voice with the 40th Comete over the EZ Comet. But that is to be expected, especially due to the price difference between the two different speakers. I'm not taking anything away from the EZ Comet, But when I listen to those 40th anniversary edition vocals, you all, yes, I can hear more emotions. You know, CDs, female vocals like Nora Jones. Absolutely love Nora Jones. And then we have Chantel Chamberlain. I absolutely love this CD. And then, yes, Susan Wong. I can hear the saliva off Susan Wong's lips when she is singing. And then we'll have some male vocals like Michael Abube. Then I have Chris Stapleton CD. Love this CD. And, of course, I go way back with John Mellencamp. Again, we have Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers. Again, Eric Clapton. And even when I'm listening to the deep voice of Teddy Pendergrass. I mean, there is such a realism, you all, to the overall vocals, listening through the 40th, that I was very impressed. That is a strong point of the 40th commentate, are those vocals. So now, let's jump straight into the bass. For the low end, or the bass performance of the Triangle 40th commentate. Now, first off, you all, the frequency response of the 40th is from 49 hertz up to 22 kilohertz. So out of the 40th commentate, you're not going to get the kind of bass that punches you in the chest or shakes your floor or even kicks in your front door. Now, if you want that, then I would highly recommend a set of active powered subwoofers. But the kind of bass you can expect out of the 40th commentate is fast bass, tight bass, bass with good speed and overall grip to it. What I would actually call nuanced bass, especially for a 6.5-inch driver. But what was really impressive to me, you all, is when I was sitting there listening to bass guitar, there was some real dimensionality to that mid-bass sound. Now, a couple CDs that I used to test out the bass or the low-end performance of the 40th commentate. Yes, I have Daft Punk. Very good recorded CD. Also, I have Bell Effect CD. Really good bass. Again, here we have Metallica Black. And I have, Octave Records Audiophile Masters of Volume 3. Really good recording. And yes, I got a Notorious B.I.G., Tupac, and even Dr. Dre. So the kind of bass that you're going to get out of most stand mount speakers are that mid bass. And I will tell you, the mid bass is very impressive on the 40th commentate. Now, they are rated at 8 ohms nominal impedance, but they go all the way down to 4.2 ohms minimum impedance. So one thing I did learn very quickly with the 40th commentate is, you all, they do like a little bit more power than the regular Triangle Esprit Easy Commons, which are rated at 80 watts, and the 40th are rated at 90 watts. But one thing I can say about the 40th commentate is the bass is very well balanced. Meaning, as I'm cranking up that volume to these 40th commentates, the bass really maintains its composure in those louder volumes. You know, it doesn't have that smearing effect or bleed off. Now, if you own the 40th commentate, you probably already know what I'm talking about. I mean, these speakers, you can actually crank them. The only kind of setback that I had with the 40th commentate, you know, in the low end, is when I was using my smaller, lighter weight Class AB amplifiers that weighed like 20 pounds and under, only at low listening volumes, I wish there would have been just a little bit more extension. But this wasn't a problem at all once I started turning the volume up or I used a little bit bigger size Class AB amplifiers. You know, my amplifiers weighing 25 pounds plus didn't have that problem at low volumes having that bass extension. So I know a lot of people want to know, hey TJ, what is the overall bass extension of the 40th commentate? And I will tell you all like this, speakers like my Polk Audio LSIM 703s, which is basically a three-way speaker, you know, that speaker has a lot of bass extension. It does have more than the triangle 40th comitate. But the comitate has more dimensionality to the bass. It sounds more accurate, you know, compared to the Polk Audio. The Polk Audio might even sound a little bloated and a little bit slower than the 40th comitate. Don't get me wrong, I love my Polk Audio LSIM 703s. I'm just trying to give you all a better understanding of that bass extension with the 40th comitate. I will tell you all this, the louder I turn the volumes up, the better the low-end bass extension sounds to me. It just, you know, it needs just a little bit of power to wake it up. I know a lot of people said this with another speaker called the Bucart S400, that they needed a little bit of power to wake up. Now, I personally think this is due to the Triangle's engineers really beefing up the 6.5-inch mid-range driver. They got a new motor structure, stronger, stiffer surroundings, and the actual spider inside. The Triangle 40th comitate, I would recommend amplifiers, especially if you're using Class AB solid-state amplifiers. I would recommend, you know, amplifiers that have at least 75 watts and more, because when I was rolling through my dozen Class AB amplifiers, one thing I noticed real quickly was my amplifiers that were 75 watts and above really had more control of that lower end bass extension with the 40th comitate. You know, smaller integrated amplifiers that I have, like the Audiolab 6000A and even the Iota VX-SA3, you know, they'll drive the 40th comitate. But my bigger amplifiers done a better job of actually controlling, you know, the bass. Even the low-end extension at those lower volumes, I had better luck with my bigger amplifiers. Which, you know, the Triangle Esprit Easy Comet back here, actually, you know, my Audiolab 6000A drives it just fine. So the 40th comitate does like a little bit more power overall than the Triangle Esprit Easy Comet. But again, I think that is due to the beefier mid-range driver that the engineers at Triangle just developed. It's one of their new mid-range drivers. Now, let's talk about amplifier pairing real quick so I can end this video. And if you have any questions at all, just ask me down in the comments below. And yes, in my description box, I will upload all the audio gear that I used to pair up with the comitates. Now, first off, one of my favorite amplifiers that I had to pair up with the 40th comitate was actually my Audiolab 8300 XP power amp. Now, when I was using that power amp, I actually used my Burson preamp DAC that you see right here. I was using the XLR outputs going into that 8300 XP power amp. And let me tell you all something. I could not believe how well those two paired up with each other. But my favorite pairing overall, in my opinion, you all, was my 59-pound Dodge 10 MK2B tube valve integrated amplifier. I mean, if you own the 40th comitate, I cannot stress to you how good these KT120 power tubes sound with this 40th comitate. Now, it didn't come easy to me, you all. I had to do some serious tube rolling to get that synergy to match. I have four different power tubes and I have four different preamp tubes. And when it came to my power tubes, yes, the Tonesol KT120s were my favorite with the 40th comitate. Now, my preamp tube's favorite was actually my vintage Bremars BVA from 1962. Now, I used the Bremars in the middle as a 12AX7s. Then on the outside, I did use the Golden Lines 12AT7s. But altogether, that was my favorite, you know, power and pre-tubes. Altogether, that sound, I'm telling you all, is pretty amazing. And probably one of the only caveats that I had at all with the Triangle 40th Anniversary Edition comitates. One of the only caveats that I had is I wished that center imaging was just a little bit better, just a little bit better on solid state amplifiers. You know, this was not a problem at all once I started using a tube valve integrated amplifier, because we all know how they have such a great 3D holographic imaging to them. But another amplifier that I had, probably the cheapest amplifier, integrated amplifier that I had that sounded good with the Triangle 40th, was my Marantz PM8006. That's about a $1,500 solid state integrated amplifier, and it did pair up very well with the 40th. But overall, you all, yes, I would definitely go after a tube amp or a tube valve integrated amplifier. And until next time, this is TJ, the Stereo Bargain Valve. And please remember, you all, the number one stereo system in the world is the one you have in your home. Enjoy it.